Okay, this is probably the final step as far as putting most of the frame together. I already talked about putting this Acme net on here. This actually goes into some threaded holes right here. And one thing about this is you want to try to keep the hole over here where the bearing mount goes, the hole over here where the stepper motor goes, and the hole going through here, you want to try to keep them as concentric as possible. In other words, they need to try to line up as good as possible. Well, I already know that when we ran this prototype, when we formed this part, it was actually formed a little bit long here, which is okay, because if you form this part too long, then that makes this part too short, which you can space it out to get it to line up. If you do it the other way and you cut this part or form this part too short and this is too long, then it's already sticking out too far, and then you have to try to space this forward to get it. So but from having put this thing together and running it already before, I already know that I have to space this out, and I'm using just some washers here. I'm using a big washer and a small washer. So I'm going to take this 1/4-20 machine screw here, and I'm going to put this one small washer on it, and then I'm going to put a bigger washer on it, and then I will stick it on here and turn that a few times. And also, please note that this has to go a certain way. It looks like this hole, when you just glance at it, it looks like this hole for this Acme nut is in the center of this, but it's not. It's closer to the top here than it is here. So if you put it on upside down, obviously you're not going to have your holes lined up and concentric, so it won't work very well. So I just put a couple, turn that in a couple of threads or so, and then I can take this one, push this bolt on here, push my washers on here to act as my spacers, and then I can find that hole. Here we go. So now as I tighten this up, like I said, those are threaded holes, so you don't have to worry about putting a nut on there. You just make sure it's good and tight. And now I've actually got this spaced out so that when I bring it over to this side or to this side, it is concentric. And in fact, when I look down through this hole and look through here, I can see all the holes are lining up very well. So that's what you need to when you're putting that lead screw in there. Okay, so we've gone through and we've got all the sheet metal components assembled, as well as the Acme nuts that I just wanted to show that it's easier to go ahead and put them in as you're doing this, putting the sheet metal components together, building the frame and the Z-axis, the X-axis, and all that. Also, one thing I've already done, I didn't really videotape it, but I used these two blocks. You know, I mentioned when I put these carriage bolts in, what I did is I used these two blocks as kind of a spacer, and I'd stick them under here, adjust this so that it was touching, and then I would pull them out and just go around. That way I'd get all those the same height. So all that's adjusted. It's nice and level now. And now the next step would be to add what would be package B if you buy it from me, which would be the lead screws and the couplings, which I already, I already have those screwed on my lead screws here, and these little bearing blocks. So I'm going to go ahead and put these on, and I'll show you how that goes. Okay, there's not much to these bearing blocks. These are just some pieces that I've cut, and you have three. They're different shape. These two that are the same go right here on the Y-axis. This one here that's a little bit different shape and a little bit different mounting spacing, it goes on the Y-axis. So I already had these screws kind of stuck in here as I took them apart so I wouldn't lose them. And these just go right through here. This little bearing is just to support the end of the lead screw so that it doesn't go flopping around as it's running, which it shouldn't anyway if it's fairly straight, but will help to keep it from getting bent, things like that. So always good to have a little bearing on the end of it. Okay, and then we'll put this other one over here on this side. And then this third and final one goes right here. Okay, there we have it.